How would you go from this to this and achieve an ageless, full coverage glam on matured skin without making it look cakey? Hi everyone, it's Smitha. Welcome back. In case you're wondering, I'll be turning 43 this year. And over the years, I've learned a thing or two about how to look more youthful with makeup, even when you have full coverage. And I wanted to share those tips with you today. So without further ado, let's begin. All the products that I'll be using today are from LookFantastic. I chose the best-selling products on their website. If you didn't know, LookFantastic is the original online British beauty boutique founded in 1996, and now they're also available in the US. They are, in fact, the number one beauty retailer in Europe with over 12,000 different products, over 450 brands across hair, makeup, skincare, body care, electrical, home fragrance, organic, and they have something for everybody. I personally chose the best-selling products on their website to create this look for you. And in case you plan to buy something, you can use the code SMITHA to get a 22% off. And I'm also going to link it down below in the description box. I'm super excited that they decided to partner with me, so I'd like to take this moment to thank LookFantastic for sponsoring this video. As I'm aging and my skin is more matured now, I've come to realize that skincare is everything, and when it comes to makeup, less is more. I'm going to begin, of course, by hydrating my skin with the Hyaluron Moisture Serum. This is a deep hydration and moisture-boosting facial serum. I'm just taking a little bit in the back of my hands and applying it all over my face and neck. This serum is loaded with powerful anti-aging properties, and it has a low molecular weight, which helps the serum to penetrate beneath the skin surface, and that results in enriched hydration and a very dewy glow. It's non-sticky and leaves your skin looking soft and smooth. For a double shot of hydration as well as a primer, I'm going to be using the Ella Masca Hydra Veil. This almost has a gel-like consistency, and long ago I had watched this video from Wayne Goss talking about this, and I'd been eyeing this product ever since. This is such a fabulous product. Hydra Veils are extremely hydrating and moisturizing, while they also fill in the pores and fine lines and smooth out your skin. So it creates that smooth, clean canvas for makeup application, while you can also feel that tackiness. So when you apply makeup over this, it's going to cling on to it and last longer. I'm super excited about today's foundation. You know how much I love base makeup, a flawless one especially. Today I'm going to be using the EX1 Invisible Liquid Foundation in the shade 8. I've heard such great reviews about this foundation, so I can't wait to try this. This has an easy pump. I'm just taking a little bit in the back of my hand. I'm going to apply it all over my face and neck, and to blend it out, I'm going to be using a kabuki brush. When I use full coverage foundations, I tend to skip color correction because the foundation should be able to take care of it. Now, if you use a corrector underneath, sometimes they cake up because you're adding too many unnecessary layers. So first impression, it feels absolutely seamless. It's, as you can see, covering all the imperfections on my face. It's full coverage, but it feels like skin. Here's a trick. I like to take a dry sponge and dab it all over my face, so that removes the excess. And if you observe, I did not take the foundation all the way to under my eyes because I'm going to be using a concealer there anyway, so I don't want to unnecessarily layer and cake up. And for concealer, I'm going to be using the NYX HD Photogenic Concealer in medium. It's got a smaller doe foot applicator, which I personally absolutely love because it's easier to take it to those hard to reach areas and those corners. I'm only going to be using it around my eyes and mostly focusing it in areas where it's the darkest, like the inner corners and in the hollows where the shadows are casted. This concealer was actually recommended by you guys when I did my top 5 concealers. A lot of you asked me to try this out, and I absolutely love it. It's very blendable, it's very brightening, and it's not creasing, at least so far. Using the Ready Set Go powder by Lottie London in warm translucent, I'm only going to be setting in areas where I tend to crease, which is mostly around my eyes where I use the concealer and in my T-zone. And again, the reason I'm doing this is you don't want to cake up. When you apply too much powder, it's going to layer over the foundation and it'll not give you that natural skin-like finish. Again, coming back to the point of less is more. Instead, I'm going to use a setting spray to lock my base makeup. The one that I'll be using is Hydrate and Fix by Revolution Beauty. While this locks your makeup, it also hydrates your skin. And unlike powder, this is going to melt all the excess product and give you more of a skin-like finish. For brows, I'm going to be using the NYX Micro Brow Pencil in the shade Ash Brown. If you're looking for a dupe for the benefit precisely my brow, this is it. You get the same results for a fraction of the price. It's got the micro tip, so it's very easy to draw hair-like strokes and it gives you that natural brow finish. After I've very lightly filled in the sparse areas of the top part of my brows, I use the spoolie in the back to brush my brow hair upwards and again fill in the sparse area in the bottom portion of my brows. I love this pencil. It's very smooth. The color blends so beautifully with the brow hair and stays on the entire day. You can see how it's filled it in. On my left side, I haven't filled my brows. On my right side, I have. So you can clearly see a difference, but at the same time, it gives you that natural finish. As you know, I have hooded eyes, so I'm going to be showing you a technique to make the eyes look bigger and brighter. My crease line passes right across my lid, so if I do makeup up to my crease, you won't be able to see a thing because it's going to hide under the hood. So the plan is to create a new crease above my natural crease line to make more lid space. I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution Glow Heatwave Eyeshadow Palette. It is such a gorgeous palette, has 25 matte and shimmer shades. If you're looking for a palette that has a good mix of mattes and shimmers, something that you can use every day as well as for special occasions, I would highly recommend this palette. It is so pigmented. And if you plan to get this on LookFantastic, you can use my code SMITHA for a 22% off. I'm going to link everything down below in the description box, so do check that out. First, I'm going to dip into this beautiful brick brown shade for transition. I'm going to look straight in the mirror with a small blending brush. I'm going to mark the area where I want to build my new crease. And I'm looking straight in the mirror because when I open my eyes, you should still be able to see that crease line and the lid also appears bigger. To this, I'm going to continue to add the eyeshadow till I'm happy with the intensity and I'm going to continue to blend to buff it out. This is blending beautifully. There's no fallout and the pigment payoff is so good. You will see me use this a lot more because I can see myself creating so many looks with this palette. It's so versatile. Next, I'm taking a larger blending brush and I'm going to buff it out a little bit more before I use it in my lower lash line, smoking it out. Another trick to create a larger lid space is to use a lighter shade on the lid, and I'm going to be using this bone color shade with a flat shader brush. I'm going to do a soft cut crease. Matte eyeshadows are also known to conceal the wrinkles and texture on the lid. It softens it and it doesn't make it that visible. And as you can see, the lid space looks so much bigger. With the shimmer antique gold shade, I'm going to highlight my inner corner and brow bones. That'll also help to separate out the two eyes and make it look bigger and brighter. Instead of a black eyeliner, I'm going to be using a brown eyeshadow today to give a more softer look. So I'm going to be using this deep brown shade and I'm going to smoke it out in the outer corner of my top lash line using a small definer brush. Another product that I was super excited to try is the Ico Yoga Waterproof Mascara. Even this had 5-star reviews online. The wand itself has an hourglass shape, so it makes it very easy to use the tip of the wand to apply it in hard-to-reach areas like the inner corner hair and the outer corner hair and the lower lash. After curling my lashes, I'm going to wiggle the wand and take it all the way from the root to the tip. And because the wand has that arch, it's very easy to fit the hair in and drag it all the way up. And as you can see, that applied beautifully. It's not clumpy and the lashes look stunning. Here's the tip if you don't want too much mascara in your lower lashes or if you're afraid of smudging it. Hold the mascara wand almost upright or vertical and apply it only with the tip of the wand, especially if the wand looks like this, like an hourglass wand. It's very easy to apply it. And then use a clean spoolie to remove the excess mascara by running it through the lash hair. And that'll also help to spread the product across evenly. Here's a look at the eye one more time. This is before makeup. And here is the after makeup and what a big difference it makes. Although the eye makeup is so subtle, it makes your eye look so much bigger and brighter. Let's finish the rest of the face. To sculpt my face, I'm going to be using the Kevin Aucoin The Contour Book Volume 3. This palette has everything that you need for sculpting your face, including a few shades of blushes, a couple shades of highlighters, and three different shades of bronzers. These are matte bronzers, which can also be used as a contour powder because they do have a cooler undertone. I'm going to start with the medium bronzer, and I'm going to be mostly using it just above the hollows of my cheekbones. As we age, our skin loses elasticity and our face starts to look sunken in several areas. So you don't want to use too much contour or bronzer, just use enough to sculpt your face. Keeping your face looking a little bit fuller gives it a more youthful look, so keep that in mind while sculpting your face. And then I'm going to be using the blush. I'm just using all shades of blushes together. It's so pretty. I'm going to be applying it higher up, just above the bronzer that I just used, to give it a more lifted effect. For highlighter, I'm going to be using this shade, and rather than focusing this in the high points all over the face, I'm only going to use it around the temples and around the brows and the high points of my cheekbones. I'm going to especially avoid all areas where I have texture, because when you use shimmers over texture, it's going to show it even more. After I've sculpted my face, I use a dry powder puff and I go around my face patting it to remove the excess product again to get that skin-like finish. I'm going to finish this look up with the Burt's Bees 100% Natural Moisturizing Liquid Lipstick in Sandy Seas. This is a beautiful nude shade, looks very classy. You can also use deeper shades like a deeper red or berry, whatever you prefer. There are no rules in makeup, you just have to do what makes you feel happy and confident. And these are just some tips that I follow regularly because I get a lot of feedback when I attend parties, events, as well as from you guys saying, what do you do? How do you look so youthful? And some of you thought I was in my 20s. Now you know how old I am. And I'm so happy that I have this platform so I can share it with all of you. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please thumbs up if you did, and do check out the description box for all the products that I used today from LookFantastic. And I have also listed the discount code in the description box. If you plan to recreate this look, please don't forget to tag me. My socials are also listed down below in the description box. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.